Why am I having brain farts?
I know, dude. I was like thinking because
I got it. Give me 2 seconds to think. It's embarrassing. This is the thing. We don't have notes, guys. Like,
we're too hyped. We're too hyped with the fucking.
That, but like, we could easily have notes and shit. We don't do all that shit. Like, so, it's unscripted. It's okay. So if you're creative and you're an entrepreneur and you're trying to like land gigs, this is gonna be our topic. Say yes to the gig and figure out later. Say yes to the gig and figure it out later.
Yes.
So what I mean by that, if you are a videographer, for example, and your friend's mom sees you with the camera and stuff like that on Instagram, for example, I don't know, I'm just freaking throwing random examples, and they say, hey, my coworker is getting married. I notice you have a camera all the time. Can you do a wedding film? And you're trying to make some money, trying to make some bread, get your name out there. Say, and you've never done a wedding in your life. You've just been doing some street photography or shooting skateboards, whatever the fuck you're into.
But they've seen your work.
And they've seen your work and they see potential in you and you want to make some bread. Say yes to the gig and then figure it out later and how to do the gig.
Yeah. So, okay.
This you want to elaborate more on this?
So, yeah. So the perfect example. I knew a guy who, he was like an old coworker from a few years ago. And he would tell me like, oh, you're in photography? Like, yeah, I shot my cousin's my cousin's wedding. Mm-hmm. And then I'm like, really? Like I've seen your Instagram. Like, you seen some cool photos. I was like, yeah, but I never really posted them, but I've just kept them for myself. And then I shared it I gave her the photos when she wanted them.
Right.
And then she was like, holy shit, like these are actually good. Like these are better than my photographer who I hired. And then she showed them to her sisters.
Oh, he was a guest in the wedding.
Yeah,
he took random shots.
Yeah, he was like a hobbyist and he brought his camera.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and then he was like, yeah, my the girl I shot.
You'd never want to hear. If you're a photographer and someone's out there as a guest with a camera and they're killing it,
yeah,
bro, that is the ultimate diss.
Yeah, so she was like, yo, like she showed him the pictures of like, it's like, oh, this is some like a guest,
right,
who brought his camera and took pictures. And then her sister was like, oh, like I really like the pictures.
Wait, is this a true story?
Yeah, for real.
Holy shit.
And then she was like, oh, I like the pictures. Like, does he fucking shoot? Like, will he get paid? Like, will I hire him? And it's like, yeah, hit him up. And he did it. And it was like, he got the gig. But that's like the one of the few gigs he did.
Right.
And I was like, holy shit, like
this guy. But he still landed it.
Yeah,
he still landed it. He wasn't marketing himself as that.
He sought the opportunity of like, I'm going to bring my camera and take pictures.
Right.
He was a hobbyist and he took it and he got a fucking gig and he got paid. But he didn't like it because it was so stressful. Like he was like,
well, that's what you got to know you need to figure out what you like.
And like what he told me, he was like, man, like when I was shooting this like wedding, the one he was shooting for free,
right?
The one that got him the gig,
right?
Was like, I wasn't really like caring about what I shot. I just shot. Paid. Yeah, I was like, I just shot whatever looked cool.
Yeah.
And then when the wedding actually happened, that he got hired from his sisters,
probably added too much pressure.
He was like, oh, fuck this shit, I ain't doing this again. And he never did it again. And then it happens, you know. And but he sought the opportunity.
Right.
So remember last episode, I was like, oh, you're lucky. When I said you were lucky, and then you're like, bitch, I ain't lucky.
I'm not lucky.
So like, let me tell you something I learned. I was like, when I was doing research for this topic, there was a video I saw about what defines luck, right?
Okay.
So what defines luck? It's when opportunity and fucking your thing you've been working for, so like your work, meets opportunity.
No, of course.
So what you've been working really hard meets opportunity.
Yeah.
Then they combine and they become a fucking block, a Lego block that connects. Right. And then that's what people call luck.
It's not luck.
Though, it's not luck, but that's what this like. This
so can you not? Can you finally say I'm not lucky?
I'm not saying I didn't. I corrected myself.
Oh, okay.
So. That's what I was.
You just proved my point right there by you saying that.
No,
right?
I did. Yeah. I proved your point last episode because I said no. That's a bad word because. But this guy
it,
was
it
like,
cheapens hard work when someone says someone's lucky.
Yeah. So like, the shit you've been working really hard when it finally finds an opportunity,
right,
people call that luck, and that's what how this guy defined it. And I was like, holy shit! Like that's I'm gonna bring that up to Alberto because that's what I was trying to say last episode.
Gotcha.
But I didn't find the right words.
Right.
So. For him, my ex coworker, he was like, "Hey, like, I'm just like a hobbyist photographer who happened to be at this wedding, and I happened to like he obviously take some shots, and he was obviously like talented, and knew the angles and composure and all that.
He's got an eye.
Yeah. So he had an eye. Yes. He had an eye. And when he got the eye and he like, when the wife was, or with the bride. Fucking, the bride who was there, who invited him, was like, hey, do you happen to have those photos? And then he shared them and he's like, oh shit, these are actually good. Shared them to his sister. Sister was like, oh fuck, I'm going to hire him.
Damn.
Obviously was like, I'm going to hire him because he's not going to be very like high paid. Because he's a newbie, which I think
it is a gameplay.
It is a gameplay from the
bride's perspective. Yeah.
Like this motherfucker barely starting, rookie. Right. Let's get him.
Yeah,
let's
get her.
But at the same time, don't feel bad for the photographer because he got paid.
Yeah, and he could have said no if the pay was too low. So
yeah,
I don't feel bad.
And he got paid. Everybody win. Yeah. And that's how
he learned a valuable experience that he hates fucking shooting weddings.
Yeah, so it's a win win for him because he got paid. And he got a win because he's like, hey, like moving forward as a photographer, I don't want to do weddings because it's a waste of my time. And I'm sure it was stressful for him because like he said, when he was at the first bride's wedding, it was like, oh, like it's everybody with a camera.
Right.
You're like, oh, I want to shoot this. I want to shoot that. But you're not being forced to shoot like, hey, come here. Shoot this.
Mm-hmm.
And, but yeah, that's a prime example of what like, seeking the opportunity that's presented to you and taking it even though you're not experienced.
Right.
And moving forward to helping you gain experience.
For sure. Yeah. That's
a really good example. What about you?
Do you have any personal examples? When I first started, bro, I was the yes man. Bro, I always said yes to anything and I didn't have zero experience.
Bro, how did you get into weddings? Because that's a good example for you because out of the blue, out of the fucking blue, you just did a wedding.
Oh.
And I was like, what the fuck?
Okay, so my first wedding gig was actually through Teddy.
Teddy. Osuna, right?
Yeah, Osuna. Yeah. Shots to him, by the way. Yeah. Portrait photographer. Fucking amazing. He's a killer. He's a dog. He was in the frame of the week, by the way.
Yeah.
once I got back from my travels, I was gone for 6 months and whatnot. And I remember hitting up all my connects, my networking field.
I need that bread.
Yeah, pretty much. I was like, hey, dude, I'm back. I'm ready to work. Let's freaking hit me up if you need some help with anything. I will literally do kind of anything when it comes to the creative field. So I remember vividly, I was at the gym and I was like at the bags, the punching bags area, kind of like doing some abs and stretching and shit like that. And then Teddy hits me up and he says, hey, have you done a wedding before?
Mm-hmm.
I've never done a wedding before.
Yeah.
And I said, I think I said yes. I'm not sure exactly what I said. I was like, yeah, man, I do it all the time. Or something. I forget what I said.
Yeah.
And he's don't worry,
Teddy's going to check you. He's going to text you.
Yeah. Well, anyways, like he's like, hey, dude, I got this wedding gig and I would love for you if you could help me out. And I'm like, oh, dope, man. Is this paid? Because I'm not fucking working right now. Because
mm-hmm.
I wasn't sure if I wanted to go full-time freelance or go back to my hospital job.
Yeah.
And he's like, yeah, I could give you $100. I was like, damn. Fuck.
Yeah.
And,
but were you helping or was it just you doing it?
Well, I thought I was going to be the B camera. So I was like, fuck it. I'll do it, man. I don't give a fuck. I need this experience. I've never done a wedding in the back of my mind. I'm saying I've never done a wedding. So I can't expect to get paid appropriately.
Yeah.
So I took the gig. I mean, we all got to start somewhere. So guys, don't have any shame, bro. I did my fucking first wedding for $100. So a few months later passes by. I go to the wedding. And then I find out I'm thinking this whole time I'm the B shooter. So I'm doing all these YouTube tutorials, like how to fucking shoot weddings. Guess who I saw? Craig Adams fucking how to film wedding school or school. Craig Adams, yeah. So
let's give a little backstory go ahead, finish.
Let's talk about it later.
Yeah.
So I'm doing all this research on how to do weddings, how to do fucking audio, how to do all this good stuff, like what works, what doesn't work, what to avoid, what to do, how to talk to the brides, how to talk to the freaking grooms and like the parents and like be courteous, how to dress up and stuff. I'm literally doing all my research. So like I said yes to something and I'm figuring it out before the shoot. So I'm doing all my fucking homework. I'm practicing with my camera. I'm practicing with my gimbal. I'm practicing with a monopod. I'm doing all these, like I'm getting all my correct lenses and stuff like that. So I did all my fucking homework, spent hours upon hours upon hours getting ready for this, my first wedding. I get to the wedding. I fucking show up. I'm like, all right, let's fucking do this.
Yeah.
He's like, all right, cool, man. Like, your buddy's going to show up in a second. I'm like, what do you mean, my buddy? Like, your B camera. I'm like, what the fuck? Like, I'm the A camera? So we both know Teddy's a photographer. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So him and his wife are doing the photos, and I'm the A camera on the video, and I have a B camera. I was like, oh, fuck. So I'm, like, running the show when it comes to video, at least.
Yeah.
zero experience, like I said, but I figured it out at the moment because I mean, I know how to shoot. Yeah. I did all my homework from fucking YouTube University, like I said. And so, yeah. Dude, I was able to figure it out and I fucking killed it, man. Like, it was a great shoot, man. I did my 8 hours and, and got paid $100, which is like less than minimum wage. But, bro, hey, man. I learned so much that day, man. So I appreciate Tay for like even having me help out and stuff like that. Even though I got paid ass, but it's all good because I learned a valuable lesson. Like, I know what it takes to shoot a wedding. I knew, bro, when I got to my car after the wedding in their parking lot, I was so fucking drained. Dude. Like, I was like, fuck, man. Like, now I know what it takes to do a wedding. Now I know how much I should get paid for a wedding because I don't want to pay myself $100 for fucking 8 hours.
Yeah.
Like my math is trash, but it's pretty bad, though, if you were to break it down into hourly. So, yeah, that was a very learning experience, great learning experience. And I leveraged that wedding because I did some snippets and I posted on my Instagram. Leveraged those snippets to get other weddings.
Yeah.
And I freaking priced myself higher and higher and higher ever since. And I got 4 confirmed weddings for 2021. So I'm pretty hyped right now, man.
Yeah.
So that's how I got into the wedding thing, the wedding game.
Damn. I remember those stories, but I didn't know that was the timeline. That's crazy. Yeah,
those are the details.
Yeah, that was the timeline details, which I didn't know, which is pretty interesting because as your friend, like I feel like I knew everything, but damn, this is In the Frame podcast. We bring gems to the table and
there's always like little hidden details that we just don't say about, but dude, that just shows, man. Like you gotta, like I said, back to the last episode, go back to networking and saying yes to the freaking gig, even though you have zero experience in it, and figure it out later.